Today, let's reverse a piece of text string in Google Sheets and Excel. So it's going to be pretty much the same formula for both. So I'm going to start in Excel because it's easier to zoom in here. Let's start by going over the logic how this is going to actually happen. So if you look here, we have this Florida oranges here. So generally, if you just do this function equals mid, point to this text, do a comma, then I'm going to have a start number. So let's say I'm going to do 1, and then I'm going to do comma and then number of characters, again, 1. So right now, if I close parentheses and hit enter, you'll see I get an F. And the reason for that is because we set to start at number 1 and to also extract just 1 character, number of characters. So that gets us the first character. Now, if I change this starting character to 2, see, I get an L because now we get the second character and 1 character after that. Now, if I go on the side here and type something like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then go back to this, and instead of this 2, erase the 2 and just select this range of 1, 2, 3, 4 as a starting number. Instead of a single number, now I give it a range of numbers. I hit enter, see I get the first 4 characters from this text. Now, if I go 4, 3, 2, 1, then I'm gonna get them the other way around, right? Starting from R, O, L, F. So basically, if I could just start from this last number, whatever this S is, and then keep going backwards until the first character, that should get me something like this. So how can I get a range of numbers like that? So I'm gonna go ahead and erase this for a second, and we'll come back to that formula here to update this range in just a second. For now, let's just do 1. So what I'm gonna do here separately, I'm gonna use this sequence function. And for sequence function, we have number of rows, number of columns, starting number, and step. If I did something like 10 as number of rows, comma, and then number of columns, I do 1, close parentheses, and hit enter, I get from 1 to 10. So then if I do another comma, and then as a starting number, instead of starting from 1, which what it does by default, I change it to, let's say, 25. Then it starts from 25 and keeps going 10 down. And then if I go after this last character, 25, after the comma, I can also give it a step. And the step could also be negative. So if I go negative 1 as a step, we'll start from 25. See, and we'll basically go back down. And if I do 25, 25 to basically have 25 rows and to start from 25th number, then I'm gonna go from 25 up to 1. So instead of 25, what I can do, I can just calculate the length of our string right here using len function. And see, it tells us that this is 15 characters long. So for this particular case, for Florida oranges, we actually need this to be 15 and 15 to get from 15 to 1. And then based on that, if I go and erase this one and highlight this range from 15 to 1, if I enter, see, we get Florida oranges backwards like this, so Florida oranges. Now I'm gonna combine all of these in a single formula. And the way I can do that, instead of hard coding this 15s here, we can go back and copy this len function, hit escape, go back to this, and instead of this 15, I'm gonna paste that. Instead of this 15, I'm gonna paste that same len function and hit enter. And now we have a dynamic way of calculating how many characters it is. I don't need this anymore. And then instead of here referring to this range right there, I'm simply going to just select this whole sequence function without equal sign, copy that, hit escape, go back to this and paste that right here instead of that range. Now, Finally, if I hit enter, that should give me this, and I wouldn't need this. And now we have a single formula here that gets us these characters backwards. So now, to just have one piece of string, in Excel, I could just do concat function like this around this whole thing. Open and close here. So you can see how I got that backwards. But this concat function in Google Sheets doesn't do the same thing. In Google Sheets, concat function doesn't handle ranges like it does in Excel. So to make it compatible for both, instead of concat, let me actually remove this parentheses and go back to my mid function. I'm gonna go back, and instead of that, I'm gonna use this function that's available in both, which is called text join. Now text join is gonna have a delimiter. So in this case, I don't want any delimiter. So I'm gonna do double quotes, just an empty string, comma, and then ignore empty cells. We don't wanna ignore anything. So we'll just say false, comma. And finally, the last argument here is the range or text, which is gonna be this. So I'm gonna go ahead and close parentheses after this whole thing, hit enter, and now that should produce the same results as our concat would. Now that works pretty well already, but if I keep dragging this down a little more, if I have empties, I'm gonna get this error. So I probably just wanna leave it blank. So for that, we'll just add a wrapper for this. We'll go after this whole thing and we'll say if that A1 equals to blank, comma, blank, then leave it blank, comma. Otherwise, if it's not blank, we'll do this reverse thing. I'll close parentheses and hit enter, and then we should be able to drag this down. So we got our Florida oranges backwards and so on. So this same formula now should work in Google Sheets if we just add a ray formula for this. So I'm just gonna copy this, hit escape, go back to Google Sheets just to show you that, and paste it here. Same exact formula. The only thing I'm gonna do Control Shift Enter or Command Shift Enter if you're on a Mac to get a ray formula around this whole thing. Hit enter. See, it autofills it for me. Good enough. And if I fill it after, it still works just fine. And there you go. That's our reverse string. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.